Hi, today I'm going to make these lovely flowers called Erithrina. Very easy to make. Materials required are crepe papers in red and green, a thin wire, a thick wire for stem. This is a black colored pen and a purple colored crayon, a green floral tape. These are very tiny pips. Yellow in color and 3 in number. This is a tissue paper strip. All the measurements are in centimeter. This is the stencil for a small bud and the flower keel. This is 4 centimeter high and 1.5 centimeters wide. The stem is 1 by 1 centimeters. Cut one piece for a flower and 7 to 8 pieces of bud. Then this is for the big bud. This is 6.5 centimeters high and 1.75 centimeters wide. Stem is 1.5 by 1 centimeters. Cut as many as you like. This is for the sepal. This is 1.75 by 2 centimeters. Cut one piece each for all the buds and flowers. This is of the petal. This is 6.75 by 2.75. The stem is 1.5 by 1 centimeters. Cut one piece per flower. And these are the leaves. Or the leaflets. So the bigger one is 8 centimeters by 8 centimeters. Cut one piece per leaflet. And the smaller one is 7 centimeters by 5.5 centimeters. Cut two pieces per leaflet. Cut a piece of thin wire. This is about 7 centimeters long. Now I've cut a small piece from the tissue paper. So just fold it. Apply glue on it. And wind it, or covering about 1 inch or 2.5 centimeters of the wire. Like so. Then take the piece for the bud, just stretch it well. Apply glue. Put this in the center of the bud, leaving a little on the top, and close it. So you get this sharp crease on one side. Like this. Then just gently bend it a bit. Just a little bit. So it looks like this. Now take the piece for the sepal. First just stretch it on one end. Like so. Take a black colored pen and just color the outline, just the edge, sorry, of the paper. Like this. Now apply glue. Fold the side over and stick this side on it. Now just take a pencil and insert it. Sort of just push it to get this, you know, kind of a cup shape. Like this. So apply glue on the base of the bud. Put this through the sepal cup. And then just sort of roll it between your fingers so it sticks. Now this is a strip I've cut from the red paper, about half a centimeter, 0.75 centimeter wide. So just stretch it. Apply glue. Wind it like this. So this is how the bud. For the bigger bud, cut a slightly longer piece of the thin wire. This is about 10-11 centimeters long. Now in the same way as I did earlier, so this is a slightly bigger piece of the tissue paper. Fold it and I'll make it in the same way as I made the small one. So cover about 1.5 inches of this of the wire. Now just apply glue, and I've already stretched this piece, so I'll just apply glue. Put this in the center and close it. Then bend it a bit. I've made the sepal already in the same way as I did earlier, and just apply glue. Like this. Now take the strip. This is how the bigger bud would look. For the flower, the thin wire would be around 12 centimeters. Now, take the tissue paper strip. This is about 2 centimeters wide. So, just fold it. And again cover about 2.5 centimeters of the wire, so this will become slightly thicker than the bud. Like this. Now these are the three pips, so when you fold it, and then just cut the middle. So you get six of these pips. Now take the strip. Just apply some glue. Hold these pips just about 1 centimeter. Above the wire. Unwind this strip on it. So you get it like this. Now take the piece, the butt piece. This time this will form a keel, it's called. And just put it like this. So you get a shape like this. Now bend this also. you get it like this. Now take the petal. First just, you know, curve it on the top. Like so. And then just stretch the middle portion. Turn it over. And then just put your finger below this lower portion of the petal. And stretch this downwards. So you get these curls. Now it will curve in like this when you stick it. So apply glue on the stem. Now this will face downwards towards the petal. So just stick it, you know, just put it like this. And while it's wet, just push the bigger petal down. So it forms this kind of a shape. Now I've already again made the sepal. So just apply glue. So this is what it will look like. So take the red strip, stretch it. So this is how the flower would look. For the leaf, cut a long piece of thin wire. This is for the main leaf. So this is about 19 centimeters long. Now take this leaf and score veins on it. Then just very gently, very slightly pull the edges. You get a slight ripple, you know, ripple on it. Now take the green floral tape. Stretch it and bind it on this wire. Apply glue on the reverse of the leaf. And stick this wire on it. So I've already made two the smaller ones in the same way and slightly smaller wire. So now just cut another piece of the green floral tape. Stretch it. Now hold these leaves. You know the bigger curve should be towards the front side. And it should be about 4 centimeters below the main leaf. 3 to 4 centimeters. So I'm just going to put it like this. And similarly for this one. And they'll have very small pedicels, both the leaves. Now take the tape, just wind it on it. Like this. And open them out. This is how the leaf would look. I'll assemble the flower stem now. So I made a lot of these flowers, the small buds and the big buds, about 5-6 of each. Now take the green floral tape, cut out a long piece. Stretch it. Take the thick wire. And take a small bud. So give about 1 centimeter long stem for the bud. And start binding the tape. You can put, you know, one below the other or even two at the same spot. Leaving a little gap between each, about 1 centimeter or so. And then as you put to, you know, the lower buds, increase the space between each bud. I'll put the bigger ones. This will also have about 1.5 centimeter long pedicel. Again, you can put two of these together if you like. And similarly the flowers. So give about 2 centimeters of the stem. And then the leaves. So just attach them and they will have a long pedicel, the leaflets. So now just open out all of these. So I'll open the leaves. On the flowers, and then the bigger buds. So try to make them point, you know, downwards, like in one direction. So this is how the stem would look.